Hello, everyone. This is Southern Belle Whisper. I hope you all are doing well today. It is a very rainy, cold, dreary day outside. But I'm off today, so I thought I would make it a comfort movie day. I told you guys in my last video, how I've been feeling kind of down the last few days. So I was like, okay, well, I'll just make it into a comfort movie day. And there are so many movies on Disney Plus that I consider my favorite comfort movies. So the first one that I picked out to watch today was The Princess Diaries. I love this movie so much. Like, I'm a kid at heart. I love this movie. I love Julie Andrews. She's like Mother Teresa to me. Like, she can do no wrong. She's like, she has this motherly ambiance to her. And I just absolutely adore her. I swear, one day when she passes away, which is hopefully not soon, I'm gonna have to take a sick day off of work and watch all her movies and cry and eat a whole tub of popcorn or ice cream. Sorry, ice cream, not popcorn. Popcorn is for happy times. It'd be ice cream. She is definitely one of my favorite actresses of all time. Maybe not my top 10, but definitely. And then I know this is the movie where Anne Hathaway got started. And all of us know how much we love Anne Hathaway. And as the guy from, the Nutty Professor movies, I forget his name. Hold on, maybe yes. It does not. It's okay. But the funny guy, the one that plays the Apollo in Princess Diaries, I love him in this role. And Joe, the driver, the limousine driver, love him. He was also in Pretty Woman. And if you guys don't know, I have a little trivia for you guys. The part where they're having the first dinner and she clinks the glass with her butter knife and it breaks, and the waiter comes up to her and says, "It happens all the time," is the same waiter from Pretty Woman, which was also directed by Marshall. Jerry Marshall. They're both directed by Jerry Marshall, Pretty Woman and Princess Diaries. So the same actor that plays the waiter in the Princess Diaries that says it happens all the time is also the waiter from Pretty Woman, where they're at the dinner with his really important people, because he's an architect. In Pretty Woman, Richard Gere is, right? He's an architect. And he has, like, these really important people he's supposed to impress. And I think she's trying to cut into, like, a potato or something that slips out. And the waiter goes, "It happens all the time." They're the same person. Which I thought was really cool. But let's see. Let's see if there is any more. Some of my comfort movies. I love Disney Plus. I just watched Tangled the other day. Let's just do it like this. Deadpool on Disney Plus. Okay. About we'll just do throwbacks, and then we'll no, let's do because you watch The Princess Diaries. Now, The Princess Diaries 2. Now, I will tell you guys, I am so excited because I think they said there is supposed to be a third Princess Diaries. But I gotta be honest with you guys, I didn't like the second Princess Diaries. I don't think that her and the guy, what's his Pine, Chris Pine, had good chemistry. I think she had a lot better chemistry with Michael in the first one. And then, if you guys didn't know, in the books, she actually ends up with Michael, which makes me very happy. It makes me want to read the books because she actually ends up with him, like married and everything, Michael from the first movie. I'm a big fan of Michael. Second one is The Parent Trap. I watched this movie while my niece was here for my birthday. And Natasha Richardson, you guys. And Dennis Quaid. Oh my goodness. How old is this movie? 1998. So I was 7 years old. This is another movie that I had on VHS. And I was obsessed with it. So I've always been obsessed with Lindsay Lohan movies. And then it's just so good. I think it's one of the only remakes because I actually do not like the original, but I love the remake. And I can't say that about a lot of movies. But this, I thought Natasha Richardson and Dennis Quaid had such great chemistry in this movie. It just melts my heart every time. Me and my mama went to the theater to see this movie. I'll never forget. Let's see, what year? 2003. So I was 12. And we went to the theater to see it. And one of the best sounds in the world to me is my mama when she laughs. I'll never forget there's a scene in this movie. And I'm sure everybody has seen it. If you haven't seen it, then you obviously live under a rock. This one, is this one a remake too? I think it is a remake. I don't know. I think it was a remake though. But there's a scene where Jamie Lee Curtis gets a makeover, and they're already switched. And she comes to her brother's school, and as she passes her brother in the hallway, the brother goes, "Mom?" And she goes, "Yeah, whatever." And that made my mama laugh so hard in the movie theater. She loved that. And I'm a big fan of Jamie Lee Curtis. And I heard they're making a second Freaky Friday. So, my childhood heart is so happy. Ice Princess, oh my goodness. I might have to watch this one next. This one, 2005, so this one's a little bit older. It has the woman from Sex and the City, and then what's her face? Oh my gosh. I just remember being obsessed with this movie when I was a teenager. Me and my best friend at the time watched it, and we were obsessed with the song. And actually, there's a song in this movie that was in the movie Just Married, which was another movie we were obsessed with because she was in love with Ashton Kutcher, And there's a song at the end of Just Married that was in this movie. I think, like, in the middle of the movie, it plays, and we, like, looked at each other, and we were like, oh my gosh. Gosh, to be a teenager again. But I really like this movie. I actually really like, I'd watch it again. Maybe not today. I don't know. I don't like the guy, the love interest. I don't mean to sound shallow or anything, but I don't think he's handsome enough for her. So, maybe College Road Trip. That's a funny with Martin Lawrence, 2008. So we're getting into older movies. Sorry. But this one's actually really funny. An ever-protective dad joins his daughter in search of the perfect college. And it's got Raven Simone. Raven Simone. Confessions of a Teenage Drama Queen. I watched that movie one time when I was, let's see how old I was. 2004, so I was 13. And obsessed with Lindsay Lohan. And also Megan Fox is in this movie. She plays a bully. And it was alright. It's not one of Lindsay Lohan's best movies, in my opinion. Mary Poppins, it's been years since I've seen this movie. I'll have to watch it sometime. Like I've told you guys before, I'm not a huge musical fan, but I do love Julie Andrews. Alexander and the Terrible, Horrible, No Good, Very Bad Day, 2014. It's one calamity after another during the worst day of Alexander's life. Why? And it's got Steve Carell and Jennifer Gardner in it. I have never heard this movie. If it's good, let me know and I'll watch it because I love Steve Carell. And Jennifer Garner is one of my top five favorite actresses of all time. So if it's good, let me Holes. Oh my goodness. This movie is so good. 2003, so I was 12 years old. The Yelnats family curse lands young Stanley at Camp Green Lake. What I love about this movie is that people still quote that one scene every day. The scene where she's like, I'm tired of this, Grandpa. And he's like, you're too damn bad. You keep digging. Like, people make TikToks out of it and everything. I think it's hilarious how this movie stays alive just because people love quoting it. But it's actually a really good movie, though. It's got very young Shia LaBeouf in it. Sigourney Weaver, the one guy, Angelina Jolie's dad, John Voight. It's really good. It's The Game Plan with The Rock. I remember watching this movie for the first time in my classroom when teachers would play movies all the time. This is one of the movies we watched. I was 16. And I'd never seen The Rock in a movie before. Of course, I'd seen him. My cousins were obsessed with WWE. So I'd seen him wrestling, but I'd never seen him in a movie before. And I actually think he does really well in this movie. And one girl, I forget what her name is, I recently saw her in an American Pie movie, and I was like, dude, I think it was called Girls Day, American Pie Girls Day or something. And I was like, dude, come on. I was like, she'll always be that little girl on the game playing to me. I mean, it was, and then she was in that, you saw that movie. I've seen this movie a couple times. Let's see what year it came out. Hold on one second. It's wanting to freeze on me. 2011. So I was 20 when this movie came out. Yep, I was 20. I thought the guy, the love interest, I've got something. I've got, like a weird fetish with guys with long hair, and I thought this guy, the love interest, was so cute when I first watched this movie. Another movie that I used to be obsessed with when I was really, really young was called Teaching Mrs. Tingle. I don't know if you guys have ever heard of that movie, and actually, I was way too young to even watch it, but the love interest in that movie had long hair, and I don't know what it was about me with love interests with long hair. Yeah, there's just something about it. I don't, this was a cute movie. The blonde girl, she was also in Friday Night Lights. She kind of got on my nerves. Her voice is really high pitched, and that always gets on my nerves. It's okay, movie. I don't. It's okay. Man of the House with Chevy Chase and Jonathan Taylor Thomas. It's been a long time since I've seen this one. That was 1995. Oh my God, I'm so old. I was 4 years old when this movie came out. It's got Chevy Chase in it. I love him. And Jonathan Taylor Thomas looking super cute. I'm so old, you guys. I'm getting so old. The Pacifier with Vin Diesel. I don't know if I ever watched that one, but please don't come for me. But I'm not a huge Vin Diesel fan. I don't really like Fast and the Furious. Yes, kill me. I remember I went to go see the seventh one with my ex-sister-in-law, and, cried because that was the one with where they did the memorial for Paul Walker. I'm a big fan of Paul Walker. I just never really liked those movies. Haunted Mansion. Now, I've heard great things about this movie, and they're coming out with the second one, or they're coming out with the remake. And I can't not, I can't say I've ever seen it. I love Eddie Murphy. A family comes face to face with 999. Grim, grinning ghost and creepy old Gracie Manor. I need to keep this one for Halloween. I will watch it this Halloween. There's the original Bear Trap. Like I told you guys, I'm not a big fan of the original. Jungle Toot Jungle. That's a Tim Allen movie. A Wall Street mogul learns he has a son who's been raised in the jungle. I love Tim Allen movies. I actually think he's really funny. This one came out when I was 6 years old, 1997. Honey, I Shrunk the Kids. I watched this for the first time about 2 years ago, I'm guessing. I like that actor. These movies just keep making me feel older and older. What is this movie? The Happiest Millionaire. An immigrant finds a butler position in the home of a millionaire. 2 hours and 50 minutes. No, thank you. Blank Check. I'm sure I saw this one when I was younger. I'm sure I watched it with my brothers. 1994, I was three. Herbie, another movie that I watched religiously because I loved Lindsay Lohan. 2005, so I was 14. And I think her love interest was Justin Long in this movie. And I was obsessed with VW Bugs around this time as well. Flubber. Robin Williams. 1997. Oh, Robin Williams. Okay, let's do a couple more. And then we'll end this video. Romantic. Oh, there it is. The Little Mermaid. This is the live action Little Mermaid that I have not seen yet. It's 2 hours and 21 minutes. Now, don't come for me again, but out of all the Disney movies, The Little Mermaid is probably one of my least favorites. Please forgive me. I just probably need to watch it again. Beauty and the Beast. My number two favorite Disney movie. There's the remake, which was pretty good. I love Emma Watson, so of course I was going to love it no matter what. And it actually had a really good soundtrack. Aladdin. This is the live action with Will Smith as the genie. Oh my gosh. I have no interest in watching that. Pocahontas. Another one I watched as a little girl. Not as religiously as most of the Disney movies, but Lady and the Tramp. Oh my goodness. That movie was so cute. My mama used to watch that one with me all the time. And she would sing with the dog that, you know, sang, "He's a tramp, but I love him." That song. Sleeping Beauty. Another one of my least favorites. 10 Things I Hate About You. Oh my goodness. I've seen that movie 100 times. Oh, there's Enchanted. I might watch that one today. I do love Enchanted very much, actually. We'll end it on this one because I think this is the one I want to watch next. Because I love it. It came out when I was 16. I love Patrick Dempsey, and I love he gets a happy ending in this movie. I mean, my God, I'm sorry. He gets, you know, like, you know, how was Sweet Home Alabama and Grey's Anatomy, Patrick Dempsey never got a happy ending, but he did get, I mean, oh my God, I said it again. You know, a happily ever after. There we go. He got a happily ever after in Can't Buy Me Love, which is where I first fell in love with him. If you've never seen Can't Buy Me Love, I definitely recommend it. It's one of my favorite 80s movies. And he was, you know, a lot of people say, oh, he was so nerdy in that movie. No, he's freaking nerdy cute. He's not nerdy, he's nerdy cute. And then as the years went by, he just got cuter and cuter. But anyways, yes, I do love this movie. Yeah, I think I'm gonna watch this one. Anyways, I love you guys. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll be talking to you soon.